Going back to financial markets now, Philippine shares stretched their winning streak to a fourth straight day. The main index soaring to the 6,600 level after gaining over 1% or some 76 points. Value turnover improved to over 7 billion pesos. The PSEI is also up 2.6% for the week, marking its sixth straight winning week. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're joined by Corinne Chan of COL Financial. Good afternoon, Corinne. Welcome to Market Edge.
Hi, Stanley. Good to be here.
Good to have you here. Now, the PSEI is above 6,600, ripe for a correction, especially those who would like to, of course, lock in gains from previous rallies. In case that happens next week, which level would you consider a healthy retracement for 66 or maybe 6,500 level to be considered stable?
Yeah, so from what we saw a while ago, there was a bit of profit taking this morning, but the PSEI did manage to close above its first resistance level of 6.5. If you take a look at the past 2 months, the index is now up almost 14%. Right. This was likely driven by the strengthening of the peso, the recent pullback of the 10-year treasury bond rates to 7.2%, and the strong corporate earnings that we've seen so far. So given that the index is still above its first resistance level, if it does continue its upward momentum, then we could see the PSEI test closer to its second level of resistance at 6.7. Should this fail to do so, we could see the index come closer to its support at 6.2.
All right. A lot of people are also on the lookout for hot money, which is back in positive territory in October with foreign inflows clocking in at $83 million, reversing a four-month drain. Now, do you expect this to be the trend ending 2022? And what could make foreigners leave at this juncture?
Yeah, we've been recently seeing a lot of foreign money come in. So I think the main reason for this is because of the recent rally in the PSEI. But aside from that, they're also benefiting from the stronger peso. Recently, we saw foreigners buy bigger banks and consumer companies, especially after the strong third quarter corporate earnings. So in the consumer and banking sector, we saw the reopening of the play theme continue to play itself out. This led to strong growth for retailers and restaurants that saw higher foot traffic, as well as manufacturers that saw higher volumes from the return of business and consumer confidence. For the banking sector, it's obvious that they're bound to benefit from the BSP's policy rate hikes, as this will allow them to reprice their loans higher. But then if we do see the peso weaken again to 59 levels, then this would make Philippine investments less attractive to foreigners.
All right. December is another month. There is an IPO, Premier REIT, whose price is, of course, down 50 centavos, which is now at 150 apiece from the previous 2 peso target. Now, is this an attractive price already? And what are your projections for this public offer being the last for the year?
So at the new offer price of 1.5 pesos per share, the implied dividend yield of PREIT is at around 9%, which gives investors a 160 basis point spread over the current 10-year treasury bond rate. So the recent strong performance of the market is a positive sign for this upcoming IPO. But note that the recent REITs are offering strong returns as well, especially with the C-REIT having a dividend yield of close to 10% next year. Right. So we will have to wait and see how the market will react when it lists next month.
All right. Another item, least covered mutual funds. Let's talk about these a bit, the UITFs as well as mutual funds. Now, how did they do this year with all the volatility, particularly those in the equities unit? Because it's easy to say that they just reflect market ups and downs, but it is also a fact that some products are better managed than the others, resulting in decent net asset values ending the year. Now, which ones did better under bearish conditions, Corinne?
So overall, funds that allocated a larger portion of their NAV to fixed income did much better year to date. But over the last month, we saw equities rally significantly,
right?
With the improving investor sentiment here in the Philippines. So if we take a look at last month, bond funds were flattish, while equities rebounded to almost 8%.
Okay, how's take-up sales for a lot of these items and products, given that there is, of course, inflation, times are hard, and people may be reallocating money elsewhere, especially those who are investing in UITFs and mutual funds?
So the take-up recently has been very good. We're seeing more people invest in the stock market, especially with the recent dips. So also, we're seeing 10-year treasury yields come back a bit from its recent high of 7.7%. So we're seeing more interest now in the equity market.
All right. Lastly, those invested, of course, with a longer term horizon may not need to do anything right now, but the rest of those in the short and medium term are now reviewing their positions for 2023. Now, what do you tell your clients who are making such hard choices right now?
My only advice would be to prioritize fundamentals at this point. Despite the recent price surge, fundamentals are still attractive. The PSEI is trading at a 13 times PE, well below its five-year average of 16 times. So investor outlook on the market has also been improving, which explains the recent surge in the PSEI index share price. So given this, investors should take advantage of any weakness or sell-offs in the market and position themselves in reliable blue chip stocks, as historically blue chip stocks in the index led market recoveries.
All right. Thanks a lot for your market guidance, Kerwin Chan of COL Financial. Good afternoon.
Thank you so much, Stanley.